Hi everyone, welcome. Hope you're doing well and are enjoying deploy so far. My name is Kamal Nasser. I'm a software engineer on the App Platform team at DigitalOcean. You can find me on Twitter and GitHub. That's my username right there. And the goal of this talk today is to give you a quick intro to App Platform and to show you how to build and deploy your first web app on it and also scale along with it as it grows. Now, there are many different types of web apps out there, and to list just a few of them and to very broadly generalize, you've got static sites, files that are completely static, there's no processing logic while the app is running, you've got monoliths, you've got microservice-based apps, you've got traditional server-based ones that render everything on the server itself, they don't do any client-side rendering, you've got JavaStack apps. So if you've seen my colleague Jake's talk, you've seen him deploy an RSS reader app that is a React-based client-side front-end and an API written in Django running on the back-end. And there are also a bunch of different programming languages that you can use to write or build your applications. Now, all of these types of apps can run on App Platform. And the cool thing is the process of deploying a static site on App Platform is just as simple as deploying a microservices-based app or a JAMstack app with an API or in static site front-end. And that's because App Platform does so much for you behind the scenes. So everything from integrating with your development workflow, the build process when it's compiling and building your apps, to deploying them and running them live on the web. So no matter what programming language you're using for your app, App Platform is able to take that and build it into a runnable application for you. You don't have to worry about configuring HTTPS, dealing with certificates, web servers, or anything. That's all taken care of for you. And on top of that, all of your apps are backed by a worldwide global CDN, so your apps will remain fast to all of your users around the world. And you can also make use of that CDN for caching. So even for API-based applications with dynamic responses, you can make use of the CDN to cache those responses on the edge. And also, as you make changes to your application, all of that is rolled out with zero downtime to your users. And if you push broken code, for example, there are built-in health checks, so your app will be automatically rolled back to the latest known working version, so your users don't notice any downtime at all. Now, I've already seen a couple of talks about App Platform so far, so I'm not going to spend too much time talking about the product itself. Instead, we're just going to go ahead and drop into a live demo. So I have this website here. It's just one page. It's a static HTML file. And the source for it is on GitHub right here. So let's go ahead and try deploying it to App Platform. So I'll go to my control panel and click on Create App. Here I can select my repo, so I'm going to type in the name. That's fine for the name of the app. Amsterdam is fine. Select my branch. And here I have the option to auto-deploy code changes. So what this means is that if I have this turned on, any changes that I make to my main branch, so any commits that I push to it or any PRs that I merge in, they will automatically be picked up by App Platform and deployed for me. So I'm just gonna leave that enabled and go ahead and click Next. Fishing for my code, it's detected that it's a static site and static assets. That's fine. I don't need to configure anything here, so I'll just click Next. Is this the starter plan for static sites? That's fine. And I'll launch it. Okay, and now my website is being built and deployed. So I'm just gonna wait for that to finish. And it's done, so let's try it out. I can click on this URL that was assigned to my app, and I see my website, just like that. My website is now running on App Platform. Now let's try something out. I'm gonna go back to the repo, go into my index.html file, edit it, and let's change the title here to hello or something. Then I'll commit the change to my main branch. And if I go back into the control panel in just a few seconds, you'll see that App Platform has already picked up the changes that I just made, and it's going to deploy them to my live running site. And it's done, and you can see here the deployment references the commit that I just made. And so if I go back to my website, reload, and you'll see that the changes took effect. Awesome, so it's just deployed the static site to App Platform. Now let's go ahead and try something a little more complicated. So this time I have this website. It's just a landing page for this microblogging platform that I'm building. It's a Laravel app, it's written in PHP, and right now it's just a single page. It doesn't use a database or anything, and the source code for it is on GitHub right here. So let's go ahead and try to deploy this app on App Platform. So just like before, we click on Create App, select a repo here. Microblog's fine. Just like before, I'll keep all this as is. Click Next. and it's fishing for my code again. Now, one of my favorite things about App Platform is this notion of app detection. So you'll notice that previously it detected that our website was a static site with just an index.html file. But this time it's detected that we have a PHP app that's running. It's a web service, an always running process that is publicly accessible to the internet. And it's also detected a way for us to run this application. So it's detected a run command that starts a web server, and it also uses the public directory by default, which is a common pattern for Laravel applications. So with app detection, it can dig into your source code and figure out exactly what kind of app you have in there. And based on that information, it can pre-configure things for you. And you can see it already done that right here. Now this is a good start, but we do need to define a few environment variables that Laravel applications expect. So I'll go ahead and add a few of them. So we'll set the app environment to production, and we'll set our application key, and this will choose to encrypt. And what this means is that the value that I entered in here will be encrypted when it's stored on the app platform services, and it will be decrypted only when it's made accessible to Laravel. And then the final environment variable is app URL, and this needs to be the URL where my app will be publicly accessible once it's up and running. Now, I don't know that yet, but what I can do is make use of these bindable environment variables. So it's kind of like a templating system for environment variables. So I can just type in app URL like that, and this will be replaced with the actual URL that my app will be accessible on once this environment variable is made visible to Laravel. So this is all set. I can go ahead and create my application now. So just like before, App Platform is building our application for us, and we can actually click on this details link and dig into the exact logs of the build process. So you can see it first installing Node.js, and that's because Node.js is one of the dependencies that my app needs. And it's installing my Node modules, it's installing PHP and the extensions that Laravel needs, it's installing my Composer dependencies. All right, so it's finished building and it's been deployed, so let's go ahead and check it out. And we have our landing page. Okay, so I've also been hard at work building out the actual microblogging platform, and it's now ready to launch. So I'll go and merge in my PR that contains all of this work. And I also need a place to store the posts that are posted on the microblog. So let's go ahead and add a database to our application. So I click on Components, Create Component, Database. I have two options here. I can either add a dev database that clearly says it's not recommended for production, but it's perfectly fine for this demo, or I can attach an existing database. So I'll just stick with the DB name, the dev database, Postgres is perfect. I'll create and attach it. And now the database is being provisioned and attached to my application. Now we just need to tell Laravel about this database so it knows how to use it. So I'll go into my microblog, edit the environment variables, and you'll see that I have this database URL environment variable here that we didn't have before. And I actually didn't add this myself. So when I added the database component, App Platform automatically added this for me, and it's set to another type of bindable variable. And this time it's referencing a property of one of the components. So remember, we've named the database DB, and this will be replaced by a connection string that contains all the necessary credentials and information to connect Laravel to my database. So I actually don't need to make any changes right here. So I'll click close. And this has already been picked up by this deployment that's in progress. So I'm just gonna wait for that to be done. Okay, so it's just finished deploying. Let's go ahead and check it out. I'll go back and refresh. And I get an error. That's not good. Let's find out what's happening. So I'll go back to the control panel, go into the logs tab. These will be the live running logs of my application. And if I look at the logs, scroll up, try to figure out what's wrong, we'll see that I've got this error here that says undefined table, relation post does not exist. And this is because the database that I attached to my app is completely empty, and my Laravel application expects to have my tables and everything set up in there. Now, some people like to run their database migrations on every deploy, but for now I've just decided to run them manually. So what I can do is go into this console, and this will drop me into a live shell with my running application. And I can type in php artisan migrate, pass in the force flag because this is production, and it's migrated my tables. Okay, so now it should work. I'll go back and try it out. And there we go. I've got my website. I can log in, choose a username, and I can write a post. Now, there's this checkbox here that says attach a random photo. Let's just ignore that for now, and you'll know why in a few seconds. But for now, I'm just going to save this post. And it's posted, refreshed, so there, it's using database. So everything seems to be working, right? Laravel is using my Postgres database that I attached to it and storing posts in it. Okay, so now my website is good to go. I'm going to share it on Twitter, Product Hunt, and all these amazing websites. And fast forward a bit, I'm getting so much traffic, people love my website, and they're already requesting new features. So one of the features I've decided to implement is this feature of attaching random photos to your posts. So people like to personalize their post a bit, and I decided that that could be a cool feature to implement. So when you go and write a post, you'll see this checkbox that we ignored just a few seconds ago. So the way I've decided to implement this is because I'm getting so much traffic and I don't want my website to slow down, I decided to process these random photos in the background. So when you write a post and choose to attach a photo to it, what will happen is that the post will be immediately published and in the background, a photo will be downloaded and then attached to it. And to do that, I needed to use a queue runner. So I decided to use Laravel Horizon for this. So Laravel Horizon will be a continuously running process that will watch for the new jobs and schedule them to be processed for me. So let's go ahead and set that up. Laravel Horizon needs a Redis database to store the jobs that it's working on and also to maintain state and communicate with its workers. So we'll go into the Components tab, click Create Component, Database. This time we'll go with an existing database. And I've created a Redis database on my DO account, so I'll just select it here. And it's named RedisDB, that's fine, attach it. And now it's been added to the components that make up my application. So I've got the Laravel component, the Postgres database, and now the Redis database. So now we can set up Horizon itself. I've created another component, this time choose Worker. Now Worker is a continuously running process that does not accept HTTP connections, which is pretty much exactly what Horizon is. So we'll choose my repo again. Name it Horizon this time. So now it's using Worker because I had selected that earlier. And we need to change our run command to, instead of starting a web server, we need to start Horizon. So I can change it to PHP Artisan Horizon. And just like before, we need to add the few environment variables that Laravel expects. So you'll see that database URL was automatically added for me here. So I'm going to add in the rest of them. And we also need to tell Horizon how to access our Redis database. I'll add in a Redis URL environment variable. And just like with the database, I can do RedisDB, that's the name of the database, Redis database component, and then Redis URL. And I've also added these three environment variables, cache driver, key connection, and session driver, all set to Redis, and these tell Laravel to use the Redis database for these things. And finally, because I'm downloading actual photos and image files, I need somewhere to store those too. And I've decided to use DigitalOcean Spaces as an object store for those files. So I just need to give it my Spaces credentials and connection information. So I've got them right here. And finally, we need to tell Laravel to actually use Spaces for storing files. So I'll just set these two variables to Spaces. Now, one last thing. Laravel Horizon comes with a web dashboard that lets you see stats and information about it. And my application takes a Horizon key environment variable that's set to a password for that dashboard so that not everyone can access it. I'm just going to set this to Horizon. It's not a great password, but it's good enough for this demo. So let's review our environment variables real quick. I think I've got everything in here for Horizon to work. We'll go ahead and create it. And now Horizon's added to my growing list of components. So I've got Laravel, Horizon, and both databases. Now, all of these environment variables that we added for Horizon, we also need to add them to the Laravel component, and that's because Laravel itself also needs to know about the space, where the files are stored, it needs to know about the Redis database so it can connect to Horizon. And so I'm just going to do that off camera real quick. I'm just going to copy and paste everything we've added to the Horizon component. Okay, so now I've copied and pasted all of them, just save it. And we're just going to wait for this new deployment to go out with all of these environment variables that we just added. Okay, the deployment is finished. Let's check it out. I'll go back, write a new post, and this time we'll choose to attach a random photo, save it. Photo attachment schedule, check in a couple of seconds. So now it's downloading the image in the background. So if I reload, I should see it, and there you go. I've got a photo attached to my post. What I can do is also go to the Horizon dashboard, enter the username and password we set, And here we can see some information and stats about Horizon. So you can see the number of jobs that were processed, the pending, completed, and failed jobs, and things like that. Now, one thing I want to highlight is this Insights tab here. Now, if you go into it, you can see that for each of those components that we have, we can see some insights on the CPU usage, memory usage, and that's true for databases and the worker components as well. So we can keep an eye on these stats to figure out when we need to scale our application up, if we have a memory leak somewhere, etc. Now, there's one last thing that I want to do. This whole time, we've been using this domain that was assigned to our application to access it, and I think it's about time for us to assign a nicer one to it. So I'll go into the settings page, and under domains, I'll click edit, add domain, and I'll go with blog.shark.fyi, and we'll see that it asked me to add this CNAME record to my DNS for my domain. So I'm going to copy it, go to my control panel, add a CNAME for blog, paste in the value, create it, and now it should be good to go. So I'll go ahead and edit. And now my domain is added to my app. So it's building it in the background. And what it's doing here is it's setting up the mapping from the domain to my app. It's setting up the HTTPS certificate and all of that stuff. So that should be done in just a few minutes. And now it's done. So you'll notice that up here, the URL was changed to use this new domain that we added. Let's go ahead and try it out. And there we go. We've got our app running on this custom domain that we assigned, all with complete HTTPS auto-configured for us by default. Okay, let's zoom out a bit and take a look at what we've got so far. First, we started from a fairly simple Laravel application that just had one page. It didn't use database or anything, and we got that up and running on App Platform. And then we were ready to launch our microblog, so we added those features and we needed a database to store the posts in. So we spun up a Postgres database and attached it to our app. And then we were ready to launch our application. And it went so well, people were asking for new features, so we added the ability to attach random photos to posts. And so we added a Horizon key runner in the background, and we gave it a Redis database to use. And finally, we connected everything to Spaces so we can store those images that we were downloading. And this whole time, we were enjoying all the benefits that you would expect from a production-ready platform. We had automatic HTTPS configured by default. We had zero downtime upgrades when we were rolling out all these features to our website. We were able to look at the logs for our application, check out insights like CPU and memory usage to see how we're doing on the different components. So that's it for me. I hope you found this useful and are already itching to try deploying your first web application to App Platform. If so, that would make me incredibly happy. I'd recommend checking out the sample repos that we have in the control panel. So we'll see them when you create a new app. At the bottom, you'll see a bunch of sample applications in different programming languages. So you can check them out and see how they work on the platform. And they're also all open source, so you'll find them on GitHub on the DigitalOcean account as well. Thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of Deploy.